Watch out for my butt!
So exciting. I get to commit my voice to celluloid.
Hi, I'm Olaf, and I like warm hugs.
We've really crafted some unique characters, and the casting was a huge part.
Love, come on!
Yeesh. Each person was fantastic in just making their character grow even bigger.
Oh, this is so nice.
All the actors are bringing so much to these parts. They bring the magic.
Got him!
It'll be like landing on a pillow, hopefully.
I never knew what I was capable of.
It is not nice to throw people!
Whoa, feisty pants. Don't. Okay, relax. Just calm down. Calm down!
All right! I'm okay.
Just let the snowman be.
I'm calm.
Great. Oh, come on.
I have wanted to be a Disney princess as long as I can honestly remember. I think it was the first goal I ever set for myself when I was 4 or 5 years old.
I'm here. I'm back.
There is a lot of me in Anna. Jennifer and Chris, the directors, said, go crazy and do whatever you want.
Don't you look regal?
And in reading it, I just felt like there's so much further that I could push this as far as being in an awkward situation and how I, Kristen, would react.
You look beautiful.
Thank you. You look beautifuler. I mean, not fuller. You don't look fuller, but more beautiful.
You always have a video camera on you because they want to see what Kristen's doing with her face or with her hands. And so Anna definitely has a lot more facial expressions than a normal Disney princess. She's a lot more like me.
Let me just get around you there. Thank you. Oh, there she is. Queen Elsa. Me again.
She's a little bit more human than a lot of the princesses we've seen portrayed.
For the first time in forever, I finally understand.
Singing has always been a big part of my life, so to be able to work with Bobby Lopez and Kristen Lopez, the two best musical theater writers out there currently, it's just been a dream.
This is so nice. I wish it could be like this all the time.
Me too. So much fun for me to play this character.
I know how to stop this winter.
Love will thaw.
Elsa is not this villainous character. She's extremely complicated and misunderstood.
Oh no, what have I done?
I love this process. I love going in, putting the headphones on, and just playing with my voice. It's what I do.
Conceal, don't feel, don't let them know. Well, now they know. Let it go, let it go. Can't hold back anymore.
I love the song Let It Go because it's larger than just the character. It speaks to anyone that's holding back something that makes them special and unique. We all do that in certain ways. What a relief to finally find those points in your life where you just are able to let go and be completely who you are.
The cold never bothered me anyway.
I remember being a kid and acting out Disney cartoons and pretending I was different voices and different people.
What?
It's literally the exact same thing, except now I'm just doing it in front of a microphone at Disney Animation.
I'm gonna tell him.
Somebody's gotta tell him. Jennifer and Chris really set up an environment that makes you feel like you're a kid again.
I'm thinking a snow anchor!
You're doing things a million different ways, and what if we did it like this? It's really creative and joyful.
This whole thing has ruined me for helping anyone ever again.
But she'll die on her own!
I can live with that.
But you won't get your new sled if she's dead.
Sometimes I really don't like you. All right, Sven, you ready?
Oh, Kristoff, I love this one.
Reindeers are better than people.
Because I voiced Kristoff and Sven. It's like a weird, bizarre, psychotic, hilarious duet between me and myself, sort of, but me and Sven, the reindeer.
Don't let the frost bite.
I'd like to formally apologize for hitting the Princess of Arendelle with my horse, and
for every moment after.
It's very odd seeing your voice come out of something that's not you. It's great, but it's really weird. Glad I caught you. Hans is an awesome character play because he's not what he seems at first, but no one really is. In defense of Hans.
Can I just say something crazy?
I love crazy. And I know little girls in tiaras are gonna go to this movie thinking they're gonna see me as Prince Charming, which you do, but then you also see me as a terrible, terrible man.
Oh, Anna. If only there was someone out there who loved you.
What?
So I'm a little worried about the backlash, but it's a great story, and I'm honored to be a part of it.
As your closest partner in trade, it seems only fitting that I offer you your first dance as queen.
Duke of Wesselton's voice is just annoying. I mean, he's always, he's conniving, you know? He's got that kind of, he's figuring things out.
Open those gates so I may unlock your secrets and exploit your riches.
Did I say that out loud?
And then when things go wrong, he becomes the voice of irrational fear.
Look, it's snowing! Snowing, the queen has cursed this land!
My sister's not a monster.
She nearly killed me!
The fun thing for me with this was, you know, the dance moves.
Like an agile peacock. Like a chicken with the face of a monkey. I fly.
And then you can see that ridiculousness put to Disney animation. It's really, it's very satisfying.
Ah, my neck hurts. Is there a doctor that I can see?
1 second.
Oh,
are you okay?
Are you kidding me? I am wonderful! All right, let's start this thing over. Hi, everyone. I'm Olaf, and I like warm hugs. If there's something that the laws of physics, or even beyond the laws of physics, snow can do, the Disney animators here have absolutely discovered it, and they have utilized it for Olaf. This guy goes through it all. Because it's such a physical character, so much of the recording of this character is to literally do the By the time I'm done recording, my voice will be fried because I have not said a single word of dialogue. I've just screamed and grunted for 2 hours straight. No! Okay, where are we going? Doing this character, I wanted to give that like childlike enthusiasm with that little just hint of a lisp. I don't have a skull or bones.
Because you've got these great buck teeth that the animators created. And I wanted to really, in terms of the vocal portion, bring that to life. Bring that sort of kind of like, oh my goodness, kind of spiking my voice up there a little bit so that you get a sense of that, so that you understand that childlike quality that lives in him.
What? Hey, whoa! Oh, I love it even more.
It is very odd because you do watch it back and you're like, wait a second, do I really look like that? And then you look in the mirror and you're like, oh wow, that character really does exist inside of me. The animators are so expert at taking what makes me me and infusing it into that character. And it's always fun and eerie to see that.
Does it look bad?
No, you hesitated.
No, I didn't.
You just give them your voice, and all of a sudden, they give you a world.
My own personal flurry!